Hi, it's Tom the Man back on Island TV, and we're at another million-dollar view place here on the island.
Yes, this is Great Bay, actually a very, very popular destination for cruise ships that come from around the world. And as you can see, the Allure of the Sea, the largest cruise ship in the world, is here right now. So it's a really happening spot, a ton going on, lots of bustling activity. Take advantage of the water sports or the shopping and dining. Phillipsburg is not to be missed.
Phillipsburg's right down here. There's a boardwalk to walk around on for you folks, and stay tuned to Island TV for more of the fun.
Is wine fine or is liquor quicker? The story about the French-Dutch border gives us the answer. The Drunk Dutchman, courtesy of Susan Campbell, St. Martin Nights Magazine. Legend has it that in 1648, a Frenchman and a Dutchman were chosen to participate in a race that would establish where the border between French and Dutch St. Martin would be drawn. Starting at Oyster Pond, the two men stood back to back and set off in opposite directions on foot around the island. The French side would be delineated from the Dutch side at the point at which the two met. The Frenchman took wine along with him for refreshment. The Dutchman opted for a bottle of gin. Apparently, the gin slowed the Dutchman down. Some accounts suggest he even stopped for a nap. When they met, the Frenchman had covered approximately 20% more ground. But did this famous foot race for space ever really take place? No. Historians say that although the legend of the Drunk Dutchman is still prevalent today, it never really happened. The first border partitioning did take place in 1648 on top of Mount Concordia. And the French did indeed claim more land than the Dutch, but that was due to the threat of the large French warship fleet hovering just off the coast, not to an inebriated Dutchman. The undefended border allows a Frenchman and a Dutchman to picnic side by side at Oyster Pond on their own respective soil. Wine and gin, optional.
Hey folks, it's Todd and Amanda. We're back again, and we're at another great place, Orient Beach. Amanda, tell us about this place.
Well, Orient Beach is definitely a sight to see. It's actually a topless beach, but there are tons of water sports activities to do here. As you can see from that trampoline just in the background, one of the many things that they offer. Now, just down the way is the Orient Bay Resort, which is actually a clothing optional resort. So no cameras are allowed there. You guys will have to take our word for it. But definitely something to check out and definitely an adventure to be had here.
Come on down and see it, folks. Experience for yourself. It's real exciting.
Driving in St. Martin is not very difficult. There are only a few main roads. They do frequently change names, however, but remember the island is only 37 square miles. Without traffic, you could lap Dutch and French St. Martin in an hour and a half. Knowing a basic sense of direction and your destination will be most helpful. Dutch St. Martin is in the south, the French to the north. Princess Juliana Airport runs east to west. We drive on the right-hand side of the road. Even the main routes narrow at times, so stay as far right as possible, especially in blind turns. For a small island, there are plenty of vehicles, and parking can be creative at best. Keep an eye out for vehicles parking or pulling out into traffic. Heading east from the airport, you will be heading towards Simpson Bay Marina. Keep in mind, the bridge opens 9 a.m., 9:30 a.m., 11 a.m., 11:30 a.m., 4:30 p.m. and 5:30 p.m. Try to avoid this area during these times. Traffic will be backed up. Continuing past Simpson Bay, you will find an intersection. Heading north will take you to Marigot, the capital of French St. Martin. Continuing north will take you to Orient Beach, well known for its beautiful clothing optional beaches. Heading east at this intersection will take you to Phillipsburg, the capital of Dutch St. Martin. Phillipsburg is well known for its shopping and is a popular cruise ship port of call. There are many beautiful beaches, natural wonders, quaint shops and towns in either direction. If you can find your way to Phillipsburg, Marigot, and Orient Beach, you can enjoy them all. While traveling through the island, please use the same good judgment and take the same precautions you would at home. Wear your seatbelt at all times. Do not leave your car running and unattended. And do not leave valuables in your vehicle. If you're traveling at night, try to stay in a group and avoid dark roads and secluded areas. If you become lost, pull into any service station or any well-lit public place.
Welcome to St. Martin. A little European, a lot of Caribbean.